Hello friends, welcome to the Technical Trends YouTube channel. I am Dharma. In this video, you will get to know what, when and how to choose stocks to invest in this falling market or at any time on the basis of the technical analysis. You will be learning some new things as always, which might help you to find the best stock to buy on your own. So this is going to be an important video for you. Stay tuned till the end. And also, I'll be presenting you two best stocks to invest in this falling market. So let's get started. So friends, as a first point, first look whether the main market is in uptrend or not. If you see this market now, from 14,750 somewhere, it started falling, and every day we have seen that great fall. In my earlier video also, I have mentioned that you can see more than 3-4% fall in a week. Like that, you can find out the reversal. Okay. And it doesn't mean that reversal is going to be like earlier. So we have already seen that in 2020, after more than a decade, we have seen great crash due to the COVID. Okay. So it is not going to be like that, this fall. But in any bull market, there will be always correction. So after certain trend, time of rally, you will see that some small correction. Anyways, that correction is going to give healthiness to the market. In that correction only, you will get opportunity to buy stocks. And that is the time to take an entry. In the name of SIP or select your own and buy on your own when an opportunity comes in your favorable stocks. So let's see some few points. So friends, so far we have seen the main primary trend where it is heading. So far the primary trend was in uptrend and now it is in correction mode, which is good. Now the next point is we have to choose the best sector and stock which is in limelight. The things you will come across through the news or by searching online. So for example, if I have to say the IT and pharma sector stocks are in boom now because of the COVID, and other electric vehicles, auto stocks, cement stocks, or internet based telecom stocks, e-commerce based and digital based stocks, those kind of stocks you have to look into invest. Okay friends, the next one is very important one. Moving averages. In point of investing, I am introducing two moving averages, those you might know, which are 50 DMA and 200 DMA, and those DMA's importance. So friends, I have already selected two moving averages and have given the days and its color. So for 50, I have given a brown, and for 200, I have given as a blue. So you can see clearly when the price is above 200 DMA, and if it stays continuously above that 200 DMA, you can see the price rising at the same time, moving average also following that price in uptrend. You can see the price trending in uptrend. At the same time that this price crossing 50 DMA, at the same time 200 DMA, and trending above and staying above this even 50. Most of the time it will stay above 50, and here if you can see, if you see that price crossing 50 and crossing 200 DMA and also crossing this 50 DMA above 200 DMA, this is called a golden crossover. So far the trend may be down when the price is below 200 DMA. So after some time, after the downtrend, when the price crosses 50 DMA and crosses even that 50 DMA over 200 DMA, that is very important golden crossover. From there you can expect price going upward only by staying above 200 DMA. So this kind of stocks you have to select. Okay friends, For example, I will show you here. If you see, even Bajaj Finance, you can see here the price is above 50 and above 200 DMA. The price is swinging above 50 DMA up and down, but it remained above 200 DMA most of the time, and price is trending upside. Okay, let me draw here. It's trending upside, and when it has crossed 200 DMA downside, then you can see that price falling downwards. So, and after crossing this 200 DMA, after some time, because of the mainframe fluctuation, it has also traded around that 200 DMA and took support dynamically at that 200 DMA place and started raising again. You can see here even it was trending above 50 DMA and 200 DMA. Let's see another example. Reliance, you can see here Reliance was above 200 DMA. Here it took support 200 DMA, it took support like that. You can see completely now it has broken 200 DMA downside. Okay, that is the price when it is above 200 DMA. Let's see some stocks which are in downtrend and below 200 DMA. Coal India. Friends, Coal India, most of the time when the market is going up, this is going down straight away. And here you can witness that the price is below 200 DMA and even below 50 most of the time. It's swinging up and down of 50 DMA, but it is most of the time under 200 DMA. So this kind of stocks you should not pick. And also here, if you see this graphite stock, 2 years before it was in absolute bull trend. It was a great multi-bagger stock. That time it was above 50 most of the time. At the same time, it was above 200 DMA. Once it crossed price below 50 DMA and the same time price crossing below 200 DMA. So this price crossing 50 DMA and at the same time 50 DMA crossing 200 DMA is a bearish signal, which is also called death cross. So friends, when the price is below 50 and 200 DMA, you can see the price falling down and completely price went down. And when it has come to 200 DMA, it has taken resistance dynamically, whereas when it was in uptrend, it takes support at 200 DMA. But now when it is in a downtrend, so DMA 200 DMA dynamically become resistance. So the price stayed below only, it didn't go upside. And when price crossed 50 DMA as well as 200 DMA, and also when 250 DMA crossed above 200 DMA, you can see the price trending upside. So this way you have to analyze your stocks while investing, and you should not buy the stocks which are below 200 DMA. And if the price is above 200 DMA, then only you should buy. Why? Because this 200 DMA is for long-term indicator. So this is a trending indicator. So 200 DMA is must for investors, long-term investors. And whereas this 50 DMA is for midterm outlook or midterm indicator. So friends, this way you have to follow these indicators while investing. So these are the importance of moving averages. Friends, next one is support and resistances. In terms of investing, this also takes a very crucial importance. So here, if you see these horizontal lines, which I have already drawn, those acted as resistance earlier when the price was below. When price came up to that level, it took resistance. Here, here,
here many times. When it crossed above that one, so it has gone upside only. You can see few resistances here many times, and it crossed above. When it pulled back, it took support again. That way it went down. Here also you can see this price range has become support and resistance. So when price was in swing, now it is going downward. You can imagine that where you can take next support. That way when the price is in uptrend and the stock is very good, you should analyze and make this kind of points by using trend lines or this kind of support and resistance horizontal lines by selecting higher time frames. So you should use these support and resistances. So in my earlier video, one of the support and resistances video part 2, I think I have given some indications how to use these support and resistances. So you can watch there. The next one is what I'm trying to tell you is try to find any chart patterns. So if you want to know the chart patterns, which also I have mentioned in my support and resistances part 2 video, the reversal patterns and continuation patterns, for example, like head and shoulders, inverted head and shoulders, double top, double bottom, ABC patterns, continuation patterns. So those are there already. You can go through, and if you don't know, even you can learn online, or if you learn technical analysis, you will come across many things about the patterns and its entry levels, target levels and stop loss levels. So many things you can come across. So friends, that's how you need to make decisions while selecting stocks. I will show you one example here. Friends, this one is Jubilant Life Sciences chart pattern. I made a video on this stock in my earlier video, which is multi-bagger stock. You can go and see there. Here, if you see that I have drawn trend line downside and also horizontal line, in which you can see one pattern, head and shoulder. Okay, so I have advised that you buy on declines. So now it is in decline, and also I said stop loss somewhere here in this fall. Okay, in this fall, if it comes closer to this range, you definitely can take an entry. Why? Because it has to take support at this range. If it crosses below, then you can ignore this stock. Otherwise, up till then, you can buy this stock and invest. So that way you can find some patterns, and through by finding that pattern, if you know the target, then basis on that, if you invest while it is in a decline mode, by investing, you can ride your price towards the target. So friends, that's how you have to choose the stocks. And also friends, one more thing, don't look for penny stocks only. So friends, and don't worry even the price. If the stock price is high, you should not worry. When as long as the stock is technically fine and it gives bullish signals and bullish patterns, if it is in uptrend, then you should take an entry. So don't go for any penny stocks sort of thing, because penny stocks out of, you know, for example, out of 1000 or 2000, one or two might work, but not every penny stock will not work. If it is a good one, it would have raised already. Okay, don't look for penny stocks, but look for better pattern one, and as explained, you look for the price should be above 200 EMA. Friends, overall, one important thing is that with technical analysis, you will be able to make trading and investment decisions. If you are beginner in the stock market or don't know what is technical analysis, then you must learn first, get experience, and then start earning with it. With your interest and determination, definitely you can reach your goals very soon. So friends, that is the thing you should be doing. If you are not confident enough to pick individual stocks, you can do SIPs even. So friends, that is how you should be doing in this falling market now, or anytime later on also you can do in the correction. Friends, these are some of the important points to follow in finding stocks for investing. There are still some more points which I wanted to cover, but I have to stop this video here as it will become too lengthy. I will try to come back later on through another video with some more value added information. So stay connected with our channel. If you feel this is an important and value added video, then please hit the like button and show your support. If this is the first time you are watching my video, then please make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon for the latest videos. To get connected with me for upcoming technical course or strategies where you will be learning more on the subject, then get in touch with our team on WhatsApp numbers 0091 9177793889. This is for India, and for abroad 0044 7782493174. Please message on WhatsApp only. Thank you. Friends, let's discuss about the best stocks to invest in this market fall. Here you can see Sundaram Fasteners chart pattern, which is from auto sector, engine parts related company, and doing fundamentally and technically very well. You can see here I've already drawn trend line, head and shoulders, which has broken upside. Okay, it's currently closed at 1559. It is in a very strong hold. When Nifty is falling, it didn't fall that much. You can see here I am suggesting to buy this on every decline. First of all, close to 500 you can start accumulating up to this level around 460 even, with the stop loss below this 200 DMA. Okay, below somewhere 370 or so. I think you will not get any problem. I think here somewhere close to 410, that would be better, your stop loss. So accumulate from 500 onwards even up to here 470. For the targets, very huge, around 680 plus. So it is going to give you more than 40 to 45%. Okay, so around 50% of the growth very soon you will get. This is going to be a bonanza stock with this video which I wanted to give you. So excellent stock, you can buy on every decline. Let's see next stock what it is going to be. Friends, the next stock is Reliance Industries. You can see I have discussed about this earlier in our video. So friends, this stock already has seen a downtrend and it is trading below 200 DMA. And you might ask me that why are you suggesting when the price is trading below 200 DMA? Friends, this Reliance is history, you know how best this stock is, and due to recent FII's investment in this stock, you know, it has grown like anything. Now it is consolidating and pulling back, and it is coming too close to previous support zones where I am expecting that this stock going to turn upward. So friends, now it has closed 1841. You can see here 1841. I'm expecting this to go to 1700 levels even. I have mentioned in my Telegram channel that if it stays below 1900, it can go to 1800 or even 1700, so even to 1600. Now between 1700 and 1600 you can start accumulating this stock. Okay, so for the target of 2400 or even high. So friends, it will give another 40 to 50% profit in, you know, no time. Friends, this is excellent stock, you know, Reliance Industries, the blue chip stock, one of the heavyweight in Nifty. So if it goes, if it starts raising, you know where the Nifty going to go. So friends, accumulate on every decline this Reliance Industries by keeping your stop below around 1450 or 1400 levels and ride as Nifty and Reliance rises. So this is another tremendous stock
as Bonanza stock in this video.
Friends, make your investment in this stock also as a part of portfolio.
So friends, with this I wanted to conclude here.
Thank you for watching, and I hope that you will benefit from this video.
If you like this video, please give your thumbs up and share among your friends and family.
Hope to see you in our next video. Till then, have a profitable trade. Take care. See you. Bye-bye.